cellular science. It's all to do with atoms and molecules, DNA, and how DNA works with other molecules. So yes, you have to do chemistry. But don't say, oh, that's a burden, I have to do chemistry. Enjoy it. If you find a particular difficulty, ask the teachers to simplify it for you. You can try to put it, apply it to everyday life. What causes ulcers and cancer? Now, I'm not a doctor of human medicine, but I try to read a lot. I know some ulcers and cancers are caused by bacteria or viruses, but not all. So it depends on what type of ulcer and what type of cancer. Like there is a cancer which a lot of women may get in their life, the cervical cancer, that one is caused by a virus. So you need to know some of them, what exactly we're talking about. Whereas other cancers, like bone cancer, is basically a problem with your cells in the body. Something doesn't work right anymore. So there's no one answer for this question. Some are caused by bacteria and viruses. Others are a failure of the immune system. Others are because of things we put into our bodies, bad eating habits or drinking habits. Would eating meat cause weakened bones? I don't think that's right. I know if you eat too much meat and you do not exercise and you put on a lot of weight, later on when you are about my age and more, you may get other problems. There's a disease called gout, G-O-U-T. Part of its problem, why it happens, is because of somebody eating too much meat. And when I say eating too much meat, you eat breakfast, lunch, supper, Monday, then you just eat, and then a lot of people eat too much meat, also drink too much alcohol. So you're starting to dig a grave for yourself. But go ahead, you need the protein. At your age, you do need the protein for your body. So don't forget to eat the meat, but also exercise. It's important. Can find out help in an engineering career? Yes. You see, a lot of buildings, but I do hope some of you or all of you someday will be able to travel and see other countries in the world. They've got very beautiful buildings. So any engineer can put up a building, but to make it unique requires an artist's eye, an artist's imagination. I believe if you do fine arts and then you have the mathematical skills to engineering, you'll become truly exceptional. I'm trying to think of a building that is familiar to most of us that shows. There's a building in Kampala, one of the malls, Garden City. It looks very pretty. A lot of people like to go there because it's comfortable. It's a mall like any other, but because of the way it was designed, I believe that was an artist. It makes us feel comfortable to stay. So yes, you do need, I think you'd have an advantage. You could do architecture, but you could also do civil engineering, any engineering course. And arts actually can be applied. Even in biology, we need people who have the ability to draw and to see detail. A lot of the things could benefit from art. Somebody would like to be an ophthalmologist, but I think you have got a question, you hear dead bodies. An ophthalmologist is somebody, the eye doctor. Those are the people I see a lot. Fear is something that is built into us. Some of it is instinctive, but some of it is built into us. And I believe in the medical school, a lot of people who go there the first time fear these dead bodies, but they have a way to make you overcome your fear. Because at the end of that day, a dead body of a person is really like a dead body of a cockroach at the end of that day, as far as the medical point of view is concerned. So there is a way to overcome your fear. If you can say, I'm going to do it, that's the challenge I talked about, then you can overcome that challenge. If you acknowledge you are scared, that's the first step, then you can say, I can overcome. After all, everybody else works with these things. I can do it. So yes, you can. You know, like what your Baba says? Yes, you can. Yes, we all can. Put the PCM technical friend, and he's a doctor. Maybe he's not a doctor in human medicine. I'm a doctor, they call me Dr. Paul, but I don't do human medicine. Maybe I do crop medicine, because I try to make plants better, try to stop them getting sick from insects and other things. But even if it's a doctor in a hospital, hospitals use a lot of machinery. When they need you to get a broken bone, the x-ray machine, the people who handle x-ray machines, and not necessarily doctors preaching people. Those people have done physics, they've had to study maths, they've had to study chemistry. They use a lot of machinery. Those pictures they take, the machines they use when they are repairing broken bones, etc. So maybe it's one of those. So it's not that you must always do biology to become a doctor. Some, I know doctors who never did biology, but they are called doctors. It depends. The term doctor is to show the rest of the world really how much one knows about a particular subject. Hopefully you all become doctors so and so something. So you can even have a doctor who's done history. So we know that person knows a lot about history. Now, there are questions.
Now, here we have questions which are really interesting questions, but then we don't have enough time. However, we shall respond to some of you. Now, which ones are we carrying? What can I do to come in here? What can I do to be having a general? Please bear with us. So, now at this juncture, I wish to call Mr. Apure to answer one particular question. Mr. Apure.